To be and to become.
Right.
To be and become.
Do something after now, do it now, and it comes to it. Okay. Does everybody remember their exercises? Let's stand up to our pledge of exercise. You don't have to stand up. Okay. This finger, middle finger, right hand, to the left, in a circular motion, picturing an almond. Moving your feet, your toes, your legs, everything. Get the circulation going. Wiggle your fingers. Okay, then take your fingers to go like this. Small fingers to the big fingers. Small fingers to the small. That gets the psychic beads activated. And that's what it does with your toes. When you're moving your toes, they also have psychic beads. So it gets all that activated. It gets you ready to do anything, whether it's psychic work or regular, just daily activities. It's the whole body meditating. Are you remembering your breathing in the morning? Seven times in, seven in, or, in and out seven times, very deeply by fresh air, definitely fresh air. And that'll get you, that awakens the body, the mind, the psyche, everything. And it'll make you also live longer. Good for the organs, it ventilates all the organs with air, oxygen, and everything. Okay. Mediumship is no respecter of persons. Everybody has mediumship. Negative people have mediumship and they use it for those reasons. However, their powers are limited to lower planes. They cannot do high mediumship and they never will as long as they think that way and end that way. When you're speaking on the platform, there's a little jingle that Clifford Byers used to say, just in the audience, and that is stand up so I can be seen. In other words, get on the platform and have something to say. Don't sit in your feet for it. Speak up so I can be heard. Shut up so I can be white. Don't go on too long. They lose. Shut up so I can be light. That's what Jim taught me. I had one with the spirit. This is when you're giving a sermon, when you've got something to say, don't ramble on or go in your sleep. And I'll get into that later. About how to prepare a sermon. I think most of you know that anyway, but there are some rules that you lay down. The more you use your psychic gifts, the more you'll develop. You use it, and you will just continually progress. If you don't, you'll stagnate, you'll be on a plane or a plateau, and it won't be good for you. You'll wonder why people are so happy. like that, because they have to use it. So when you're asking it, try to give them, unless you've got a miserable headache. If you're sick, you should never try taking them. If you're well and you just feel a little bit nervous, go on and do it, because your guides will take over. It's something magic about that platform. Once you're up there, your guides are just there. They go right through you, and it's hard to walk up that aisle and to get up there in front of all those people and all those eyes are on you. But you have to have the faith. The main thing is to forgive yourself. Don't worry about your hair. Don't worry about your liver, your clothes, anything. Just forgive yourself. Go completely out of the picture and think totally about spirit and let them take over. The word psychic, which is P-S-Y-C-H-I-C, is soul power and mind power. The umbilical mind, which is U-M-B-I-L-I-C-A-L, is the solar plexus. That is the grand central station of the nervous and mental system. They have it in the middle, that's one way to remember it, that's how it came to be. It's an inch and a quarter above your navel. That controls everything. It controls everything. In fact, when the spirit, when you're a medium, a physical medium, and spirit is extracting ectoplasm from you, it comes out through your navel. It comes out through your mouth. I think I told you all this before. It comes out in your organ. But it's the main one. It's right through. Those things come, but there's a fan. Like, I'll give you an example. There's a tumor that's been ill. We all know that. So there's a fan. I try to send some energy and so does everybody else. And the way to do that is to sit like this. You sit flat on the floor. Your hands on your knees,
down.
Sending is down. Receiving is up. So, and the spirit will take that trumpet and actually put it right on your solar plexus. They do it to me a lot. And they'll take it right out of your solar plexus to give the energy to the hand. And to take the exercise out of the body. Faith without works is dead. That's the line from the Bible. And what that means in the spiritual connotation is that you can have all the faith in the world, but if you don't put it to practice in your life, and if you don't do it for humanity, it's worthless. I mean, I've seen a lot of pious people that go to church and they don't live it. And you have to be active, you have to take a part, especially in spiritualism. It's required for mediumship to live out what you learn, to give it out, to give it back, to give so much more. Okay, I told you the fingertips have the psychic beads, that's B-E-A-D-S. And we call Jesus the Christ, which means that there are Jesus is his name, Christ is avatar, teacher, like who was Buddha is the Christ. Who are some of the other ones? Maybe Gandhi, Buddha, Mohammed, Those people are all wind showers. They are all light. They are all teachers. They are all Christ. And so we call him Jesus the Christ. Because he is one. He is the greatest one. And the one that has reached the most people. Reverend Timothy says, the fingers teach you what to do in every line of work. Use them for positive goodness. The fingertips are so sensitive to vibration, which is why psychometry works. Because you can pick up that vibration. And usually psychometry works on metal. Metal objects are easier to get psychometrized. I know it is for me. It just depends on the individual mediumship. But for me, metal is definitely, for a lot of people, metal is a lot easier to pick up on. This is the pineal gland. Right here, everybody knows that. P-I-N-E-A-L. Or psychic gland. We tend not to call it third eye in spiritual teaching. We call it the pineal. Before that feeling is far deeper than thought, which brings us to mental and physical mediumship. There are two types of mediumship, mental and physical. Mental is clairaudience, clairvoyance. That type would be used for mind. Physical mediumship is when the trumpet goes up, when actually something is moved and physically picked up. That is physical mediumship. Trance is physical mediumship. Trumpet is. Precipitation is. Now, on the law of attraction, we're going to study the different laws. One we're going to learn for a little bit is the law of attraction. And that is how our guides are guided to us. Yeah, every person, according to their spiritual development, sends a light out from their being. There is a light. Spirit will actually come to stand up and say, I was attracted by the light. And when there are a lot of spiritual people like in this group tonight, their spirit would be here because they would see those lights. And you can see other spirits besides your guides, but the law of attraction. They are coming in because of a high vibration, because the light is being sent up from the individual. Anyway, spirits are drawn to you according to your personality, according to the way you think. And they're drawn like a magnet. They have jobs in spirit just like we do here. Their jobs are to help us. The different basic guides you have, and then the extra ones you exactly know about that. Okay, you have a master teacher. You have a doctor of philosophy. P-H-I-L-O-F-O-F-Y. Okay, you have a doctor, you have a master, a doctor of philosophy, and then a medical doctor that helps with curing things, the body, physical things, body chemistry. Everybody is chemicalized for mediumship. Your spirit guides can actually put chemicals in your body and your food. They do it all the time.
In the water by your bed?
Yes. If you take... Yes. Yeah. 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 But I was trying, the reason I said medical, I'm trying to explain that it works on the physical body. And then you have your Indian. All Indians are not cheap. Some are, it doesn't matter. They don't go by titles and spirits. They are just there to help you. And Indians help with physical life. They know what you go through. And they are right there to help. So call when you're having problems with your physical life. Sometimes we might call on your guides, but especially your Indian. And then you have a joy guide. Now, the more you progress, the more doctors, teachers, lawyers, and media chiefs you'll have. You know, you attract more and more and more. I don't know if there's any limit on that. I've heard numbers given, but I don't quite buy it. I don't know if you progress, the more you draw.
Some say some come in for a certain purpose.
That's right.
Either like a lawyer or something in law, and then they leave.
That's right.
I don't know.
Well, Corrine had an example of what she did. She told her to stay out. That was a condition that should be healed. And they sent a mechanic and they gave his name. It was something that O.W. knew. And he wasn't a mechanic on the airplane, but he was sent just for that time. It's her car. He did. That's just one example. There's a million billion folks. But they are sent, some of them, for certain purposes. Those are your inner bands.
I woke up and I knew she needed me that morning, but I didn't know how to get a hold of her. She was gone.
Now I'm driving in the top of the truck and had a flat tire in front of a very bad neighborhood. And I thought, oh, they killed one of them. But I drove about 4 miles like that, and I had about another 3 miles to get to the garage. And I thought, I am not going to walk up to the middle of the house. A lady backed out of her driveway. I already passed her house, went in front of me and said, do you have a spare tire? My son will put it on for you.
That's great. The more spiritual you are, the more things like that will happen to you. Your life honestly becomes almost like a charmed life. Sure, you're going to have problems, but you get so much help that it doesn't really matter. You get all the help you need to overcome. It's wonderful.
And I heard we're supposed to love them. If we don't, then we stay.
That's right.
They're health or whatever.
That's right. You have to let your guides work for you. They work with you, not for you, but they work with you. And they work with you, and you have to let them be gracious to them. Thank them for their help above all. Spirit is very sensitive.
I didn't realize this until about 3 or 4 days ago. I had breakfast and it was icy, and it was just about that much. The stuff didn't stop. I mean, if it would have kept on flipping,
that's right, you would have been
down. And it's the first time, my God, I want that stuff.
That's right.
And I said, thank you, thank you. And for all the times I forgot to thank you.
Always thank them and realize where it comes from. Because so many of our ideas and our inspirations come from God. They come from our spirit, loved ones, our guides. They don't come from us. Not all of them. They have to have framework to work through. They have to have the basic raw material. But they are very inspirational. And they are the creative entrepreneurs. We are the creative entrepreneurs. And they do work through that way. They will work through other people. They will work through your own mind. Oh, yeah. Like that lady that's got the plural. Guys were working through her. They were saying, hey, go help that lady. and she picked up on it. So that's how it works. We are God's arms and hands and legs, and it is our responsibility to serve humanity, and that is how we serve God. And that is the only way to progress. It's the only way to get mediumship. It's the only way to have a good life.
Did you have the other day?
Yes, we did. Made sure of that. Because Lori's got a key. She can get in all on her voice. Okay. You also have an outer band of guides.
Outer band?
Yes, an inner and outer band. If you don't know your guide's name and you want to call on them all, say my inner and outer band. That's all you have to say. Those are guides that are in for a certain time or not as close. They're not with you all the time. You're always with somebody. Remember them all. Always a witness, which when you tell people that, like when I get readings sometimes, I'll tell them that, I'm scared of them because they don't want a witness all the time, but it is true. There is no nothing escapes. Nobody gets away with anything because it's all witness. It's all on vacation, in case you're ready.
You said that because it's all a lot of people can get up now, but the right way to say you die.
That's right. Yeah. Spirit will actually come and say on and say, we are recording for the occasion because you're in the hospital. Yeah, that'll do it. And you can get it and tell them about it, and it's like a form of confession. And it will happen. A confession. It's kind of like that. You tell the guys what you've done, and they talk to you about it, and you realize your error, and then you're forgiven, and it doesn't go on vacation.
Don't think you don't have to make up for it. Someone I know very well has automatic writing. And this person can be very well. And someone in spirit, this person got a letter that had about five different people's handwriting in it. You could distinguish their handwriting because, you know, if you knew it, which I did know. And this was the person said that I could tell my daughter something that she had been waiting to hear. And I had no idea in the world what it was. But this is something that she had said years ago that had influenced my daughter, and my daughter was reading about it all these years. And so she told me to go and tell her about it. So I talked to her, I saw her, and I said, there is just something you want to know or something. And she didn't want to say it at first. So, but then she said it was that was true. But this person in the letter said, please tell me because I can't go on. Don't think it's all crazy when people come with that.
I have a tape starting here, Lori, which I will give you a copy of. I'm making copies now, and I'm going to get out and call you Lori. Marilyn, a transcript of what. Okay, we're talking about guides and vacation records. Are you familiar with vacation?
Mm-hmm.
Everything's witnessed, so everything's definitely. Okay. Sometimes in a seance, they will give you the chance to discuss it and erase it. And I was just explaining that it happened to me many times, all the time. You know, maybe Ripple will come in the room and say, I'm going to say something. Yes, I was terrible today. I was negative. I was rotten. I have a terrible temper and I have no patience. She'll say, I know it. You know, she'll say, I'll erase it. I know it. But, you know, but they do forgive me. So there is that opportunity. Okay. Okay, we're going to go back to meditation. A minute. You have to be passive in movement. Tell yourself, peace, be still. Number one, you relax. Number two, you visualize. Number three, you concentrate. So you relax, you wear loose clothing, you wear no shoes. Same place, same time every day. You visualize, you see something beautiful, something that holds me to you, whether it's a seascape or a walk in the woods, you visualize that in your mind. Whether it's a person that you love so much, anything that brings beauty and brings peace to you and love. And then you concentrate on that. You will hear voices eventually. You will hear, if not, sometimes they're audible, most of the time they're in your mind. They will impress your mind. You will get guidance on your problems that way. It saves a lot of grief than to have to go to someone else and spare your soul. You can do it yourself. Some people are in a position where they can't really go to somebody else. And if we don't all have a seance room available to us, it's a good thing to do that because you can solve some of your own problems if you've got straight from your own guides. And then listen. Pretty soon you'll hear a still, small voice. And this voice will come to you at any time and give you guidance. They might even come to you in a grocery store and tell you to pick up crackers. And then I'll tell you an experience. My little guide loves to shop. She loves grocery shopping. She loves to cook. She loves to cook. And I was in the store one day and she said, "Pick crackers." I said, "I have crackers." I said, "Okay." I didn't get the crackers. I was short on money. There was a couple other things. So immediately I went over to my parents' house and my father said, "Gee, you just came from Kroger. Do you have any crackers?" I said, "You know." But the next time she told me, I did pick up something. And the thing happened. My father asked me for something. And I had it that time. I was so proud of myself. I said, "Man, you know, that's cool. I listened." But they will tell you all kinds of little things to help you out to bring joy to your life and to bring it. Make it easier. One time, this is another story about guys. I had this blind date and I was a little nervous about it. And he came to the door, and right before he came to the door, it was around Easter time. And this little plus said, "Put red jelly juice in your pocket, only red." I said, "Okay." So I did it. I said, "Fine, I'll do it." So we get to the show, we went to the movie. And he said, "Do you have any jelly beans?" I said, "Yeah, but I only have bread ones." He said, "That's the only kind I like." And it was really funny. I said, "You're not going to believe that." He said, "You're weird." But I mean, there was all kinds of, you know, things like that. Just little things that bring joy. And your guides will do that. And the more you respond to those guides and listen to them, the more they do it. And the easier everything becomes, the more fun, you know, it's beautiful. I told you about the psychic shelf being at the back of the head. Before you do a reading or anything psychic or concentrated, just add a few times. Don't beat your brains out, but light is a little bit more than light. Love is the passport to eternity. The whole idea of spiritualism, guides, and God is based on love. That is the bottom line. It is the greatest thing. Without the love, you don't have anything. No, it's according to what your needs are at the time, and according to how you progress. Yeah. aware of yourself, of your body, of your, there's a natural ebb and flow. Be responsive to that. In other words, get in touch with yourself.
You mean like meditate? Or?
Yeah, meditate. You'll notice, you'll feel when you meditate. If you'll notice your breathing more. You'll notice your heartbeat more. And things like that. And in daily life, if you're having pain or something, do something about it. Don't go on and suffer with it. It's very bad for mediumship to be in pain or, and, you know, to suffer. It's very bad for it. So, listen to your body. Listen to yourself. Keep yourself healthy. Keep your body clean. All those things are important to mediumship. I know of someone that went down in the seance room and they were dressed terrible. They had no shirt on, no shave, no teeth in, and the spirit sent them right out of the room. They said, if you can't come down here with a little respect, or a lot of respect, and you can't be clean, you don't want to be good. And they will tell you that they'll tell you to get right out. It is very important to them. They demand respect and they command it. And they need it and they deserve it. You know? And if you're, I mean, if you think about it, when you go into a seance room, or even in your daily life, you're in the constant presence of God and his angels. So that's a pretty heavy thing to think about. I mean, right now we're loaded here with spirit. I mean, all of us have our guides here and God knows who all. Also, when people pass over, there will be some new spirits. We noticed a new spirit 2 weeks ago. They will bring new spirits into the seance to learn from a class like this because they do not have the learning from their own life, so they learn on the other side, and they will bring them in to show them. So they learn from us. Our guides progress as we progress. The more we progress, the more aware we are of God's presence, the higher they go. Yes, we help them, they help us. And that's how it goes. Of course, guides are smarter than we are. They have more available to them. They have more time, if you want to call it time, more a capability to work on things because we are bound by the mundane. We get engrossed in the physical. We don't give the time that we should to our spiritual life. We really should set aside more time to meditate, to think about spiritual things, just to ponder them. I don't mean you have to go into a deep meditation all the time. I'm saying that it takes 10 minutes to sit down in a chair and think about things, or especially if you're having a negative situation. Think it through first, and then say it's going to matter in 5 years. If the answer is no, forget it. There you go. Any dark room, as long as there is no light, and you can seal all the doors from the light, yes. And also have a lock on it from the inside so that no one can come in because it might kill you if they come in.
But should you be alone or have to have somebody there?
It depends on your progression. It's better to have somebody there. When you meditate, it's good to be alone. It's also good to have a group meditation.
But I do it alone, that's why I'm saying
yeah,
that.
That's fine.
There's no
a bathroom is the perfect place to study trumpet mediumship to sit, as you call it. A bathroom is great because we usually have a lock on the inside. It's dark, and you can seal it, and there shouldn't be any light whatsoever, no light, because you won't get results from one thing. And another thing is, the water will draw vibrations. Good to do that on a stormy night. You'll find for those of you that get rooted that on a stormy, watery night, there's more vibrations in the air. There's more electrical energy. It's a good way to cleanse your trumpet if I'm talking about that. For those of you that have trumpets, to put them out in an electrical storm with water and with the lightning, put them on your back porch. And let the storm come to them, and then don't let anybody touch them. same way with crystals. Don't let anybody take your crystals. Soak your crystals in salt water every 3 days until my own vibration. Because those are your vibrations. And you don't want them solid. Those are your guidance. Nobody else. I see people passing crystals around and stuff. I don't like it because, to me, it mixes the vibrations, and who knows what kind of vibration you're going to receive right here. So, anyway, keep it to yourself, you know. It's yours.
You want to lay them down or something?
Set them straight up and let the water in the electrical energy come down. Also, before you use them, like if you're sitting in a dark session, or you're sitting by yourself, turn on the light. Put a magnetized band on it. Not too much. A little bit of luminescent paint will do the trick. As long as you can see something so that you know when there's trouble up in the air. That's what it's for. It's not to draw spirits. The more light's on it, the worse results you'll have. Because it blocks spirit. It takes away from their energy. You'll notice, like I told you a minute ago, that a certain state of consciousness when you're meditating will make you more aware of yourself. Not only physically, but spiritually and mentally aware. Develop your self-will. Your body, protect it, and you must have an even balance between the spiritual and the physical. So you have to have spiritual growth along with the physical in order to be happy, balance out God's plan of things. You see all these people, and they might have all the money in the world, but they're not happy. And the reason is because they have neglected the spiritual aspect. And that is really the most important. You can also see a very poor person who is extremely unhappy because they have not met the spiritual. And they have developed them. Don't ever be afraid. Don't allow fear to interfere with your mediumship. You are afraid to send spirit away. They know it's just like anything. If you walk up to somebody and said hi, and they said, "Oh my God," wouldn't you leave? I mean, really? You mean, I would. I'd say, forget it. I don't need it, you know? And that's the way they feel. Don't allow fear to interfere. Be grateful. One thing I always tell people is that if they weren't afraid of a person when they were in the physical body, why would they be afraid of them when they're in spirit? They're so much better than they were in physical. You know, it's natural. It's a natural law for them to be better. They get schooling over there. They get teaching. And they learn. And so I would never be afraid of a spirit. Because I know that by sending out good things, you get only good back. So there would only be good spirits around them. Like here at the church. We had a faction church a few years back that said, there are evil spirits here, and nothing made me madder than to hear that. They went around spreading salt through the whole place and cleansed it. Now that really made me mad. I went around and cleaned up the salt, I don't know how many hundreds of times, and I said, don't ever do it again, but they would sneak in here and do it. It was the most ridiculous thing I ever heard of, because this is a magnetized point. This is a light to spirit. It has been for years that they know it as a spiritualist church. They see the light coming from it. They see the light coming from the people that are here, and they know it is good. The only way you're going to attract an evil spirit is if you're evil yourself. And that is why it is good to avoid low light. discussion when you are developing a relationship. Because as a meeting, we'll pick up on the vibration. You automatically become subject to it. You will find yourself saying and doing things that I like that person without even wanting to be that way, without even being that way. But you are so sensitive, you're like a spiritual sponge. You will pick it up. You will act on it unconsciously because you are a medium. Now concerning spiritual gifts, brethren, I would not have you ignorant. That is 1 Corinthians 12 chapter. I think it's 12 verse. I'm not sure. Maybe it's 1 through 12. 1 through 12. Read that when you get to the end. It tells about the different spiritual gifts. Spiritual gifts are from the Holy Spirit. We all have them to different degrees. Don't ever compare your gifts to somebody else. Don't ever be jealous. The first place that you move your gifts is just like every one of us here. But we're all good people. I mean, we all look nice, you know, but we're all different. So that's according to spiritual gifts. Some people might have a more of a talent for something than another person, vice versa. But it all works out. We're meant to have what we're suited for. Our guides know what we're suited for. Reverend Henry say don't puddle, which meant don't go from one gift to another and keep running. Don't have scattered energy. Have focus, which makes sense. But I never knew what my focus was because I want it all. And that's just, you know, now I have more of a focus, but it took me years to get to that point. So I just, what I did, instead of wanting all of them, I just said, okay, guys, you know more than I do about it. You know more what I'm suited for than I do. So you just develop whatever, you know, I just live in America and I put it in God. Because I do that wrong. There are so many spiritual gifts that it would be hard to decide which one. You might have a natural inclination towards something, just follow that. We'll be going into some different forms of media shift as the science progresses. Tonight we'll have one more dark session and we're going to go into clairvoyance and clairaudience and playing cards, all of them. The rest of that quote from the Bible is, to every man is given the manifestation of spirit, prophet, and all. So everybody has it. It's like a rose garden. It's all there. The whole rose is there, but it has to unfold petal by petal, according to your script. The more focused you are mentally on spirit and on God, the more you will progress. Your progression will be just like that. You can wake up one morning and be a full-fledged weekend. It doesn't happen often, but it can happen. You can also be in the church, studying for 50 years and not have anything. Because the thought, the mind, and your real dedication to it, if you have it or not, you go out of body and your guys are taking up. That's right. You learn in spirit. That's right, you do. You learn at night. That's a good point. Spirit will take you out of your body. It will take you to schools on the other side. And it will teach you. I've had that happen myself. I remember those words. And I had it. So I have a friend in Sandusky that has that happen quite often. She's so busy, she doesn't have time to really to devote as much as she would like to. She did devote quite a bit, but not as much as she'd like to. They really take her out of body and take her to the school because she loves me. I am freezing in here. But she said she had a... Okay. Part one.
Is there anything you can do?
Yeah. Live a good Christian life. Be loving to yourself, first of all, and to everybody you come in contact with. Be as loving as you can. Sit down and think about it. If there's somebody that is really bothering you and they seem, love conquers all. It really does. It's a hard thing just to love your enemy, but it's an important thing because by doing that, you're helping yourself. Yeah, you really are. Because if you hate someone, or you're really negative, you're just kept starting chemicals in your own body that are ruining your medium at that point. You know? So if spirit puts those chemicals in, they will. Your spirit guide is probably working on you at night, on every one of us here, and putting chemicals in your body. If you ever have a real funny taste in your mouth, you can't explain it. That is spirit putting the chemicals in. They put them in your food. They put them in your water. They'll put them directly into your body. And when we have negative emotions, and we set up those chemicals of negativity in our body, it affects them. It takes away the mediumship. So the best way is to be joyous. Enjoy the secret of life. The secret of living. Enjoy it. No matter what the situation. And I told you before, the more you progress, the more the negative comes right along, just like a railroad track, side by side. And but you also have the spirit help to overcome. So the best way is to be joyous, be loving to yourself and to everybody you come in contact with as best as you can. It's not easy. Forgiving, yes. Yeah, very forgiving. And bless the person. If they do something wrong to you, bless them. I have an ex-husband that it took me years to say it sincerely. You know, I mean, he's done some really great things, and it took me years. But I finally, after, you know, it's like being to become. It's like if you do it enough times, it becomes real.